What is up, y'all? How are you guys doing today? Right now, I just finished a little saltwater session. I've been so obsessed with saltwater recently. As I said, like, in a couple videos ago, man, once I start in the salt, it just, like, I feel like I just need to, I don't know, I feel like I need to fish it more, you know? I don't know too much about it. It's a lot of fun. Unfortunately, today, I did not really do what I set out to do, but that is all good, man, because actually, a couple days ago, I got some cool footage. Me and my buddies, Leo and Dave, we went out to the Jersey Coast Shore type of thing. It was a really, really fun day. At first, we were going for a tog. At first, we were going for tog, and then we switched it up a little bit. Such a freaking fun day, man. So you guys are gonna get to see that footage right now. Here we are, y'all. Salty, beachy air, nice warm sun beating down on us. So as I said, the first fish we were targeting this day was how do you actually say it? Is it tau tog? A lot of people refer to them as blackfish. We're just gonna call them tog for the sake of this video. These fish are freaking crazy, man. You guys are gonna see why in a second, but this is the rig I had. As you can see, it's just a little dropper loop. 40-pound fluoro leader, and why, yes, that is a brand new fishing reel I just bought. On the hook, we had some cut green crabs. So these fish are extremely tricky to catch for a couple of different reasons. First of all, they live in the rocks. They live in rocky areas. So when you're fishing for these fish with your weight or jig or whatever, you have to cast it directly, like pretty much into the rocks or holes around the rocks. You are going to get snagged and snapped off when doing this kind of fishing. Like, it's gonna happen. These fish are also just very tricky to hook. I mean, they're certified bait stealers. And also to add to that, they're extremely strong. So if you do hook one, they could just run you into the rocks, shred your line up. But yeah, man, these crazy fish were the ones we were targeting.
Dude, some of these boas freaking fly through this inlet. Oh, there you go. Ah, you find any good holes, yo?
No, not really.
There you go.
Like, what in the... Come here, boy. Come here, boy. Let's go. Finally. Oh my God. This thing's been messing with me for freaking.
Holy crap, man.
All right, y'all. There we go. That is the target species that we were after for freaking forever, man. A little tau tog. Here in New Jersey, they have to be 15 inches. So this guy's not going to pass it. But man, these guys are so frustrating to try and hook. Oh, Leo's got one right there. Yeah, man, the teeth on this thing are crazy. Look at those teeth, man. They just sit in these rocks and they're so frustrating to catch, man. They just nip and nip. But there we go, man. Beautiful little fish, not gonna lie. It's a really pretty fish. Freaking frustrated, man. All right, whew, let's let him go there. There we go. There we go. Smaller hook, smaller fish, but I mean still, man. Fish is a fish. It has been freaking tough today. Here we go, man. Little tog, second of the day. Knew they had to be like smaller fish. Let's get him going. I slimmed down my hook big time and I put a tiny, tiny piece of the green crab on. Like, this is how small I'm talking. Like, that is a freaking tiny hook, dude. All right, man, let's try to do that again.
So we fished for tog for like hours, and I mean, we used like 3 dozen green crabs up. It was a lot of fun, but it was just really frustrating, you know? No keepers, and they were still togging, but I switched things up a little bit. I put a gulp 4-inch swimming mullet on, and I was gonna try to catch some flounder.
There's a fish. There's a fish. Fish on. Let's go. Let's go, dude. Just switch to the gulp. Come here, buddy. This feels like a decent flounder. Honestly, this feels pretty decent, dude. Oh my gosh, dude. It's not as big as I thought it was. Whew, feels good though, man. All right, guys, there you go, man. First flounder of the day, second species here. Whew. That was literally on the first cast too, man. Freaking gulp is doing it. All right, I'm gonna let him go. It'd be sick if I catch a keeper flounder, man. Yo, how big do they have to be here?
18.
18?
Yeah. Not very easy, but it's achievable.
There we go. Dude. Oh, what the heck is that?
Oh my.
This is multi-species now, dude.
Little black sea bass, man. I thought you were a flounder.
There he is, man. Let's get him back there. 3 species. Not too bad, man.
That's a little...
Nobody saw that, right? There's a fish. There's a fish. It feels like a decent one, actually. I said it the first time, but this actually feels a little bit bigger. Dude, it's pretty decent. You think? Dude, still put up a freaking nice fight. There you guys go, man. Second flounder of the day. Dude, these things are so freaking cool looking, man. That guy's a little bit short, but he put up like, dude, that fight felt so good.
This gulp is freaking putting in work.
All right, buddy. Back you go.
As y'all can see, man, such a fun day. I've been super obsessed with saltwater recently. This fall, like probably in like a week or two with the fishing, it's gonna start to pick up, especially the saltwater fishing. And we are gonna have some pretty cool videos on this channel, man. By the way, my friends that I went with, Dave and Leo, y'all probably already know Leo, but yeah, I'm gonna leave all their info in the description below. Now I have something that I kinda wanna talk to you guys about. So I've been the owner of this vehicle behind me, 2004 Chevy Impala, since junior year of high school. Like the moment I got my driver's license and I could drive to school, I picked this guy up right here. Years and years later, it's still kicking kind of. Like I feel like it's getting around that time where I really should be picking up a new car if I want to go and drive places, if I want to travel more in my car, but I don't know, man. Now for like ever since I can remember, I always said that my next car was going to be a Subaru WRX. I wanted the World Rally blue color. I wanted the 6-speed manual. Now at this point in my life, I still really want that car. Like, that is my dream car at the moment. But the thing that's kind of holding me back, like, is that practical really for what I do? Now, yeah, it is four-wheel drive. It is freaking sick car, but I don't know, man. On the other spectrum, I was kind of thinking, like, what would be more practical? And, I mean, I kind of narrowed it down a little bit. I mean, trucks, SUVs, that sort of stuff. I do have a kayak, and I plan on getting, like, an even better kayak and doing a lot more kayak fishing. So, I mean, something with a roof rack or something I could stick in, like, you know, the tailgate. Also, something that would drive on sand would be pretty freaking cool, and I could put some cool content on the channel with that. I just don't know, dude. There's too many options. I mean, I've never really seen myself as like a truck guy, you know? I was never like, yo, I want a truck. But at this point in my life, I feel like that might be the most practical. I could get one of those like back things, you know, like the shell things, and I could even like take it places. I could camp in the back of it. I could put my kayak in the back of it. I could carry big stuff. Even go off-roading on the beach, go to sandy places, go off-roading anywhere else. Man, dude, I don't know. I need your guys' help in the comment section below. What do you guys think I should buy? Should I get an SUV? Should I get a Jeep? Should I get some sort of truck? Should I get the WRX that I've always wanted? I've driven this thing for so many years, man. It's just, you know, it's just time. So if y'all could help me out, that would really, really mean a lot to me.
Back at the crib right now, I just finished up editing like the whole everything you guys just saw. Now, before I say anything else, I just want to kind of put a disclaimer here. So as I was editing, I was kind of like looking through everything and I really didn't like film that much. I just have so much fun and we get so into the fishing that I just like kind of will get better at that, man. I really hope to get on some nice fish with them this fall. I really, really, dude, it's just so exciting, man. Pretty much all I'm saying is that these saltwater videos that I'm going to be posting, you guys are going to want to see them. One thing I'm really excited to get back into as well is surf fishing, like surf casting. Dude, I had so much fun with that last year, even though I had absolutely no clue what I was doing. I mean, this year I still probably have no clue what I'm doing. But yeah, before I start doing that or just like even talking about that, I just want to know, man, do you guys want to see more saltwater videos? I don't know how many times I can say this, but I've been having so much fun in the salt. It's like a whole new world. It's crazy because when you're fishing freshwater, like most of the time the fish are somewhere. I mean, if you're fishing a pond, you know the fish are in there. When you're fishing the whole ocean, It's such a completely different ballgame. Of course, it's gonna be like mixed content. I'm not gonna switch to like saltwater only or anything. I mean, trial season is coming up super, super soon, guys. I think the middle of October. I'm freaking excited for that. I guess I should also mention this as well. So we went tog fishing like early in the season. Like this is pretty early. I think the limit was one in Jersey in the fall. But I mean, this is like, in probably like a couple weeks, it is gonna be really, really good tog fishing. I might go back, I probably will go back. Actually, I might be doing some tog fishing here in Delaware. Dude, I don't know, man, I really wanna get on a keeper tog. I've never got on a keeper. I really would like to try one. I'd like to give it a little taste test. That'd be a pretty fun video to make. But yeah, we got the tog. I actually ended up hooking on some flounder, and I mean, we got, what did we get? A little sea bass as well. And other news, man, these hats are still up for sale on the website, FirstStateFishing.com. I've been freaking wearing this thing like every day. And also, guys, the t-shirts are still on the site. And hoodies may be dropping pretty soon, man. I just want to take this time to thank each and every one of you guys for watching this video, man. It really Like, all the support is crazy. You guys have any recommendations for cars? Like, seriously, cars, SUVs, trucks. I definitely need to get something new in the near future. Let me know if you guys like the saltwater. Let me know if you want to see me fish for a specific saltwater species. Pretty much, I mean, I was not even going to make this into a video, but I looked over the footage. So I decided, like, what the heck, man? Let's just throw it together. I hope you guys don't mind the lack of B-roll too much. But if you guys did enjoy this video, feel free to give it a thumbs up. It really does mean a lot. And also, man, if you guys do enjoy my videos, and if you're not already, make sure to go down there. Hit that subscribe button, and if you never ever want to miss an upload from me, hit that notification bell. And even freaking, dude, sometimes notifications don't get sent out. So if you guys never ever 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 want to miss an upload from me, go follow me on Instagram. I always post a story that says, like, you know, I just posted a video, and you can just swipe up and watch it. Yeah, guys, that's pretty much going to be it here for this video. It is probably about to get light out pretty soon. This room is getting freaking hot, so I'm gonna end this thing right here. Again, man, I just want to thank each and every one of you for the support. Let's keep this rolling, man. Thank you guys for watching. See you next video.